still not got help.
शिवा
यस मैडम, गुड इवनिंग मैडम, थैंक यू मैडम.
गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग. सो हैव फाइव मिनट्स, लेट देम जॉइन फॉर 10 और 15 स्टार्ट.
ओके मैडम, इट्स ओके मैडम, थैंक यू.
ओके. Shiva, unmute
Yes,
you.
madam.
4:10 we will start. Okay, so let them join. I will give time for joining. Okay.
Okay, madam. Okay.
Participant, please mute your mic. Balu sir, Balu Subramanian sir.
What is sir?
Okay, shall we start the program?
Okay, sir.
Good evening to everyone. On behalf of Zoology Department, I welcome our resource person, Scientist Shiva, and participant connecting from various places for the webinar on fishery resources and future fisheries. Welcome you all for the webinar. I'm very happy and proud to introduce our resource person, Dr. Shiva, Scientist, Fishery Survey of India, Mumbai. He did his BSc in Arjarana Arts College, Cheyyar. MSc in Aquaculture in Nandanam, Chennai, PhD in Marine Living Resources, Andhra University. He started his career as an aquaculturist in Jayapuram Aquaculture Private Limited, Chennai from 2003 to 2004. Then he has promoted as a senior technician cum farm in charge in Jayapuram Aquaculture Private Limited 2004 to 2006. In 2006, he got research fellowship in Fishery Survey of India, Chennai. From 2009, he became a scientist and posted in Fishery Survey of India, Vishakhapatnam. In 2015, he has transferred to Fishery Survey of India, headquarters, Mumbai. Area of research is aquaculture system, fish taxonomy, fish species inventory, marine species, fish biology, fish stock assessment, fishery resources survey, fishery resources management, code of conducting for responsible fisheries, conservation, sustainable fishery, future fishery, etc. He has published more than 90 research papers in reputed journals. He has experience in field of culture fishery, capture fishery, participate in FAO Norway research ship, species identification, project with ISRO, and marine fishery census. He undergone number of training in national and international level. He has visited Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, and Japan. So once again, I'm very proud and welcome our resource person, Dr. Shiva. Welcome you, sir. Platform is yours.
Oh, thank you, madam, for your nice words. Good evening to everyone, my professors and students and other experts, my seniors, those who are participating in this year. Then I think I won't take much of your time. Then directly we can go to our talk.
Present your slide.
I hope all are audible to me, and I am audible to everyone.
Yes. Audible, yeah. And visible also. Your slide also visible. It's no problem.
Yeah. Thank you, okay. Madam. Then we'll start.
Okay. Thank you. Okay.
Okay, this session we are going to see the fishery resources and the future fisheries. Then slide view, we can see that mainly we are targeting only students. How they going to come to this particular field of fisheries? How they are interested learning fisheries and other activities in this? Then the same way for mind reading and the teaching purpose only, this has been prepared to somewhat enlighten their knowledge in the field of fisheries. Thereby here introduction type of fishery, sea ocean, what are they, then EEZ, what is the EEZ, and the fishery resources and the fishing methods, and the fishing operations, fisheries world and India, export and earnings. For India, potential yield, what are the resources we have? We have stock, what are the resources we have exploited more and more? Then CCRF, what is the CCRF? Everybody should know the things. This is the Bible of our fisheries. Then again, marine research and international level, how they are carrying out, what are the equipments they are having on board, how they are designing the ship to get the resources, exploit the resources from the seas. Then again, aquaculture systems, how developed in our countries, how present status, everything. Then again, future fishery, based on this, based on the above, how future fisheries will be there, what is the present status, and what will be the future like that. Then again, fishery institutions and the colleges to educate the students, the dedicated institutions are there in our nation. Nationwide and the state-wise. Then again, job opportunity after getting the degree of fishery-oriented things. Then, you know, the Indian fisheries, the fishery itself, our ancestors made so many things to get it done, to see how this developed in particular things like that. That we, so many things by traditionally, even king and other ancestors also, they were doing so many practices to get the fish, then utilize that fish particular nature and the resources to need up our food requirement and the nutrition requirement, everything they were fulfilled in the smaller way. Then day by day it was increased. We need to depend on that, like that condition is there now. So most of you may be knowing the what is fish, like that, even though they just want to define in this forum, like that a fish can be defined as aquatic cold-blooded vertebrate having pins for locomotion and gills for respiration. This is the simple worldwide accepted meaning for fish. Then what is fishery? As per the FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, it is an United Nations organization in Italy, Rome. It says that the sum or range of all fishing activities on a given resource, it may also refer to the activities of a single type of fishing. Example, beach seen birds, fishery or trawl fishery like that. Again, they are defining that the fishery can be artisanal or and industrial, commercial, subsistence, and recreational, and can be annual or seasonal. This is what FAO was telling. That is the international standard. Again, fisheries. The fishing is the capture of aquatic organisms in marine, coastal, and inland areas. Marine and inland areas, together with aquaculture, provide food, nutrition, and a source of income to around 80 million people around the world, from harvesting, processing, marketing, and distribution. Same way, for many, it also forms part of their traditional cultural identity. One of the greatest threats to the sustainability of global fishery resources is illegal, unreported, and unregulated fishing. The fishery, these are the main port. The IUU fishing nowadays prevailing a lot, disturbing a lot to the systems. Then types of fishery. Capture fishery. Then you can say simply the fishery only based on capture, another one will be culture. So the capture from the wild, the culture from the farm and the lake, other pond systems and all. The capture fishery definition is telling that the capture fishery refers to all kinds of harvesting of naturally occurring living resources in both marine and freshwater environments. Whereas in culture fishery is the cultivation of selected species, selected candidate species in confined areas with utmost care to get maximum yield. The seed is stocked, nursed, and reared in confined waters. Then the crop is harvested. Culture takes place in ponds, which are fertilized and supplementary feeds are provided to fish to get maximum yield in the given time. Same way, the word we easily can, then culture fishery, aquaculture can easily catch the people. So aquaculture is the breeding, rearing, and harvesting of fish, shellfish, algae, and other organisms in all types of water environments. There are two main types of aquaculture, marine and freshwater. Again, now we come to know sea or ocean of the world. See, the continents and oceans, what are they? Which are surrounding us? The water surrounding the continents are all connected to form one big ocean. This big ocean is broken up into five different parts. This is a major one. Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Antarctic Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and Indian Ocean. Of the ocean, there are many smaller seas, gulfs, and bays. Altogether, water covers 75% of our Earth. So you can see the sea. These are the things, major sea we were mentioning that. The Pacific Ocean is the deepest and area wide more. Then in Pacific Ocean itself, a trench maximum depth of 11,000 meter trench is there. That is the Mariana Trench. Again, we are in the Indian Ocean. That is the 24,000 feet. Almost 7,455 deeper things is there. That is in a trench, Sundas Trench. Same way, these are the things available in Google also. You can verify the things. Then we come to Indian waters. As we are in the peninsular country, that is, we surrounded by three seas, Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, and the Indian Ocean. Then Bay of Bengal, where it is the large but relatively shallow embayment of the northeastern Indian Ocean, occupying area of this much 839,000 square miles. It lies roughly between latitudes 5 degree and 22 degree north, and longitude 80 degree and 90 degree east. It is bordered by Sri Lanka and India to the west, Bangladesh to the north, and Myanmar and the northern part of the Malay Peninsula to the east. Arabian Sea. The Arabian Sea is a region of the northern Indian Ocean, bounded on the north by Pakistan and Iran, on the west by the Gulf of Aden, the Arabian Peninsula, and the south east by the Lakshadweep, that nothing but Lakshadweep Sea, and the southwest by the Somali Sea, and on the east by India. Same way, Indian Ocean. The Indian Ocean is the third largest of the world ocean divisions. About 19.8% of the water on Earth's surface. It is bounded by Asia to the north, Africa to the west, and Australia to the east. To the south, it is bounded by the Southern Ocean or Antarctica, depending on the definition in use. Along its core, the Indian Ocean has some large marginal or regional seas, such as the Arabian Sea, the Lakshadweep Sea, Somali, and Bay of Bengal, Andaman Sea, or in the Indian Ocean connected. Then we come to know the area of the sea, particularly belongs to India. What are they? I said here, EEZ in the introduction slide, it is nothing but exclusive economic zone. During 1976, this has been counseled, the area adjacent to a coastal state which encompasses all waters between the seaward boundary of the state, a line on which each point is 200 nautical miles, that is about 370 kilometers from the baseline, from which the territorial sea of the coastal state is measured. And the maritime boundaries agreed between that state and the neighboring state. Accordingly, India has 2.02 million square kilometers of EEZ. Within the EEZ, what are the things to be focused? What are the main area is there to exploit? Our own things are the coastal length of India. Coastal length or coastal line, seashore, is defined as the area where land meets the sea or ocean. Whereas the line that forms the boundary between the land and the ocean or lake. We have coastal length 8,118 kilometer as per our Department of Fisheries record. The continental shelf. Also, we have 0.53 million square kilometer. What is continental shelf? The area of relatively shallow water that fringes a continent from the shoreline to the top of the continental slope. The top of the continental slope is often defined by the 200 isobars. After this continental shelf, there is a continental slope too. The region of the outer edge of a continent between the relatively shallow continental shelf and the abyssal depths. Often characterized by a relatively steep slope compared to the continental slope. Then we know that now we know the seas, then we need to know what are the resources available in the sea or water bodies. Fishery resources, normally worldwide, pelagic resources, demersal resources, oceanic resources are there. To reach out of that particular resources, what are the things required? What are the pre-arrangements we need to do? So we need to find out the craft and the gear to exploit the resources. That way, the type of fishing craft is there, fishing crafts for catching fish in the water bodies. Fishing crafts may be traditional, motorized, non-motorized, and mechanized. These are the main categorized systems available. Type of fishing gear, any tools used to catch fish, such as hook and line, trawls, gill nets, traps, spears, etc., or the fishing gears. Fishing methods again. Now we know the sea, water bodies, everything. Then we come to know the resources. Then again, how we are going to get the fish. Then what are the methods are there that we need to know. Accordingly, there are two methods, mainly active fishing and the passive fishing. In this passive fishing, the passive fishing gears are in general the most ancient type of fishing gears. These gears are most suitable for small-scale fishing and or therefore obtain the gear types used in artisanal fisheries. Some passive fishing gears are often referred as stationary fishing gears. What are they? Gill net, long line, hand line, pots and traps. This is the gill net. Just like wall, it will be there. It made up of nylon, then other synthetic material also they are making. This web dia will be different according to our targeting the species and depth, everything depends. Again, this is the long line. This is it has one basket, 5 to 7 hooks will be there on basket. In between two float, branch line will be there. In that branch line, these are the left side. You can see that branch line has this many accessories, and the bait will be there in the hook. There also nowadays we are using eco-friendly hooks. This sand line, this is me only during 2015, where operated online operation for trail purpose. Those area bottom was not uneven bottom, and all we can use this type of fishing. This single line only with the hook and bait. Again, pots and traps. This is also uneven bottom, untrawlable ground will be there. We need to rock and other area, coral area and all is there. No, there we can use this kind of pots and traps. Crab and other caught fishes we may target through these pots and traps. Fishing method, again, active fishing method. The fish captured by active gears is based on the aimed chase of the target species and combined with the different ways of catching it. There, purseine, trawl net, trolling, harpoon. This is purseine. This is like gill net only, but a different shape will be there. Then this is encircling the fish hole or fish school we are passing through, means we can encircle the things like purse only it lacks. Over India, so a lot of the state MFRA, Marine Fisheries Regulation Act, is there. According to that, they are banned this because it catches more, and even juveniles also, surface more juveniles normally available, everything it took into that. So again, demersal, bottom trawling, the name itself is telling demersal, and the bottom means those fishes are available in the bottom. That things only we are targeting through this type of net. Again, pelagic and midwater, you can see here we can't able to see the bottom. Then pelagic, nothing but a columnar in between bottom, in middle and upper surface. In between, some of these resources are available. It won't go to the deeper or surface. It will be survive in the particular zone. So that particular zone also we are targeting using this type of midwater trawling. Again, trolling, still we have in Lakshadweep seas, throwing live bait, flushing water, and attracting live fishes like tuna, skipjack tuna, and other little tuna and all. We can get through this. Harpoon fishing still in our island, maximum island regions, these things are happening. Lakshadweep, our Andaman Sea also, this thing are people practicing still now. This is the known of the ancient method, targeting only one fish, the shallow region, transparent water, they'll spike on that. Fishing method, again, eco-friendly fishing also is there. Squid jigging, bottom set, vertical long line, bottom set, gill net, like that. This is one of the squid jigging. Even fisheries have been introduced in India. This one, Japan and all, they are doing successfully for exploratory purposes. Fisheries of India introduced this one. Again, here nothing but the wire putting, eliminating the light into the water, in the deeper waters. In the night, more than 3,000 watts will be there, each ball. So that, this sepala puts nothing but squid and cuttlefish, octopus, and all will come. Other than other species, the squid will attract more this particular light illumination. Then it will come, it will attach, stick with that hook type of things, then it will come up. Nearly 1 ton overnight also we can catch through this type of squid jigging. Again, this is the bottom set, vertical long line. Again, this is a single, already told you, long line, single one, single hook will be there. Here, small books, multiple type will be there. To target the like cod and patches, we used to do this one. Both end plots will be there. Particular, first of all, we need to know the particular depth. Shallow regions only we can operate this type of net. So there were bait will be there in that particular branches, small hook will be there. So this particular resource and all, we can get through that particular bottom set. Bottom set gill net also is there. Like I told in the surface, gill net will be there. This is one adding some more weight into the net, then float both the end. Shallow waters and regions, we can operate this one. Bottom fishes and all, we can get through this bottom set gill net. Overall, this is in a single slide. You can see the views. Continental shelf is there, continental slope, and again deeper water. Sea will be there. Then what are the gear and craft and gear operating according to the depth? The simple thing you can see here. Pots and traps, where they are operating, bottom long lines, where they are operating, again bottom trawls, where they are operating, hooks and lines, then again purseine and or deeper water. So this is the method normally all over the world we are adapting. Again, pelagic resources. Earlier I told you the resources how we are targeting, but for like pelagic resources, particularly with water trawling, we are using this one. This otherwise called as the water trawling, already told you the process very similar to bottom trawling, but the operation in the column water. The use of floats, sinkers, and other boats helps to keep the net and the instrument like sonar and the net sonde are in the locating the capturing fish schools. The net sonde will be fixed in the wing of the net. Then what are the resources moving on, crossing over there, then entering into the belly of the net, everything we can easily can see through the sonar. These are the technology developed. These are the main resources from the pelagic, sardine, mackerel, and other clubfish, anchovies, and other small fish item also we are getting through these pelagic resources. This is the family, species name, and the common name. Those we are getting through the pelagic resources. And this is the acoustic survey. I told you earlier, sonar and echo sound are, with the help of this, we can find out the soul. Even 1 ton, 3 ton souls are moving over there while crossing that particular region like that. acoustic survey we need to carry out particularly per scene and midwater trawling and all. These are very important to know. These are the main equipment we are importing. Still, we are importing from the foreign countries like Norway, Japan, and all. Demersal resources, same way I told the bottom, we are targeting the bottom fishes. It is the process of towing of a tap ring bag shaped net, usually made up of synthetic webbing of varying mesh sizes. Different size will be there, wing portion will be the different web size bigger, then again throat, again belly, then again cord end will be 40 mm, 50 mm, like that will be there. So this also one of the cord end size, if you are reducing, means most of the zonals also we are getting that also one of the danger situations. These are the main resources, cod, and again perches and shrimps, lobsters, crab, lizard fishes, catfishes, and all we can get through this type of demersal trawling. These are the group, family, common name, and scientific name. Majorly getting through these bottom trawling. See, this is one of my voyage we took this picture, the demersal trawl catch. Normally 10 kg also will come, sometimes so 1 ton also will come, according to the place where we are approaching, that way it is there. So this is about 1 ton almost to perches, karkara, one species is there, komodesis, then some other resource also. Nearly 22 species altogether was there identified in this particular catch. This is also another right side. You can see that red snapper catch also during my voyage only it was happened. I think this way I was lucky during my voyage. Most of the valued fish I'm getting. To get rid of that, I'm publishing some of the short notes also about these observations, salient findings in the research front of our own publications and outside. So you can see here, after opening the cord end, there will be 6 to 7 decans will be there. They have to sort out the fishes species wise, group wise. Then the scientist work will be that what are the sizes we are getting, what are the species level, genus level, everything will need to note down. Again, biological studies, again, what depth, what latitude, what shooting time, what holding time, everything we need to note it down. Then particularly on real-time basis, realistic data we are collecting. So based on that logbook also we are maintaining. So that is needed actually. Particular species, what are the species, what is the swept area, dragging speed, everything will be there. In that we need to calculate accordingly. This particular resources are available in the particular region or this particular kilometer, particular distance, particular depth, everything we could know based on the studies. This is the thing, left side, you can see that the deck view of the stern trawler, nothing but trawl or net will be operated in the back side of the ship. That is the left side, that is the shooting, how we are shooting the net. Then right side, you can see that hauling, how it is happening. Then now, oceanic resources. Mainly oceanic resources, to exploit the oceanic resources, we and even worldwide, mainly using this type of long line gears and all. Everywhere, rarely midwater trawling, mesopelagic resources also they are exploiting, the multiple trawl and all. In future slides, I'll be informing all those things too. So what is a drip long line? Modern long line gear is used for catching oceanic fishery resources like tunas, billfishes, and the sharks. A long line gear unit consists of a long main line made up of synthetic rope, the 5 to 7 branch lines with the 2 floats on either side of the rope. A line may consist of about 750 to 1000 baskets per day we need to operate. Then only we can cover the area. Then that hooking rate and all, we can easily find out this many hooks we are updated, this many fishes we caught, these are the ranges, these are the biological aspects, everything we come to know. So the lines will be nearly about to 10 kilometer length. It will be operated in the early morning. Then after 4 hours of immersion time, we can take on board. Then what are the catches we are getting? We'll calculate that particular basket on which hook, number one hook, number three, 1, 2, 7 will be there. Which hook it has been caught. Then what was the bait fish used to catch this particular? Then which bait attracts, particularly in this type of long line, we are targeting the tuna fish. The tuna attracts more, which bait like that, everything we need to know that we are studying in this. These are the resources, elephant tuna and big eye tuna, shark and other fishes also here. Again, billfishes. As we are targeting the tuna, then allied resources like shark and other billfishes also we are getting in this. Even shearfish also we are getting, deeper water shearfishes. These are the family species name and common name, but those fishes we are getting through this long line, drift long line. Here you can see that after shooting up of four hours, we need to all back the shooted the net or line. This is a monofilament long line. So we are hauling back the line. You can see this is about 6 to 8 decans will be there to handle the things. We need to handle carefully, otherwise it will be make problem to even decans also. Well practiced and should be there for that. One man per winch operation, another man to get that branch line, another man to post to another person. Then again, another person will look after the any catches there or not, catch to be carefully taken on board. Again, another person to reel out that branch line, everything. This is when systematically will happen. This is a system. Again, here you can see in that particular monofilament long line, what are the catches are coming. As we are targeting tuna, particularly elopin tuna, that is Tunnus albicaris, we got one. It's almost a dead one because early morning we are shooting those, it will be before sunrise. And the sunrise time only, it will be very active. This particular fishes will come for prey to the surface. That particular time we are operating means so we can catch this one. The above thermocline layer only this particular tuna will be there. This is particularly elopin tuna, Tunnus albicaris. So very early morning it might have caught. So it died. Even live fishes also we are getting. You can see this one, another, as I told, allied resources, one of the allied resources is that swordfish. Otherwise, we can say as a billfish. The billfish, how big it is. Swordfish, particularly this particular species, how big it is, big one it is. How people are working to get that particular weight, live weight of that particular fish. On board itself, we need to do all these practices. This is what even foreign vessels also on the spot, whatever it is there, then particular data, live, realistic data, real-time data they are collecting. This is what the world also needed. See, 3 to 4 people, they're lifting up and getting the things. My voice only, I'm asking how much like that. The handling is somewhat difficult. Again, this is regulating with the tuna only. Tuna also supposed to move us straddling waters. this even it go to the other state even. We have EZ, it won't listen to us. I won't listen to you, I won't stick to you, like that it will say indirectly. It will cross the border even, Sterling or stock, we can use it to say this one. Accordingly, we need to find out where it is going. We need to put a tag on that, like that our scientist with collaborative projects were studied this thing. Accordingly, wow, we can tag like that to many, after many research, we imported this thing with the collaborative agency, a tag, pop-up tags. Then during voyage, you can see the how seas are moving. We need to dance every day. Our blood circulation, everything will be changed for 20 days. Each scientist will be for 20 days out at sea. Like that way, I'm having nearly thousand days out at sea. So how carefully they are taking live tuna to tag, then we need to monitor that particular movement, how long, how depth it is going, like that. In this pop-up tag, we can know only the, when the fishes come to the surface, so because that tethering will be, you know, connected to the satellite signal. The satellite signal only record its movement. That particular pop-up tag injected to particular tuna fish up this much length, this much weight, this much latitude, this much depth we have got. There only we tagged this one. As on date, this particular fish moved to Sri Lanka or Bangladesh or this way, like that we can come to know. Accordingly, after tagging or after 3 months, we have on record is that one of the fish were got signal from the Sri Lanka coast. You can see how carefully, nicely handling the fish and injecting that pop-up tag, then again releasing back to the sea. So quite interesting subject. Many of you can be interested. Please learn more and more about this sea. Open ocean is a bigger one. So lot of things is there to learn day by day. Every day we can learn so many things in the sea. Lot of unidentified animals, lot of things are there. So only thing we need to know the things, we need to have a different idea. How we can get it done like that. We need to think of it. How vigorous. It's a live one. It's nearly about 40 kg. Single fish, 40 kg. Yellow pin tuna it is. We need to add that eye. Otherwise it will be disturbed. It will become more vigorous. Then the tag will be ready. In the second dorsal pin of that particular fish, we need to inject. See, the injector with that like syringe only. Son of my senior. Dr. Sinha. See, they're taking measurements also, total length. And weight also, they will take live weight, everything. After taking, they will inject. See? That is the particular second dorsal pin region. You can see how they are fitting in that particular bone will be there. Inside it will be open like a spring. They need to stick into that bone. Pin. So now we need carefully need to be released back to the sea. Yeah, still it's live. This is well known technology. Still, we need to know a lot and lot about this study. We need to understand the animal. Even it will take even time. These are the process how we are getting inside, and adding the eyes and injecting, and again releasing back. The life is swimming post. Then again, during my recent visit to the Japan, this one of the fish market, only for tuna fish market, particularly in the early morning to before 1 o'clock in the morning, it will be over. Those are the ships, international ships are crossing over there in the particular region. Even Japan, they will unload their catches to get a good amount in that. Then again, I was told about this eco-friendly fishing methods for jigging, bottom set trap fishing. Actually, how it will be in the sea is like that. Again, type of fishing craft, still we are using catamaran, even fiber boat and all also come. Even though we are using catamaran, still now these are the methods and craft we are using still now, when I'm updating the same thing according to the season, according to the sea. So craft will be varying. Vessels, you can see as a research ships, almost in this almost all the vessels I have participated in the pelagic, midwater, demersal, and even long line. Here it is in the much Sugandhi is there, that is the school jigger come long liner, the vessels. This is almost even Fish Reserve of India having this one. Now out of 12, only 11 vessels we are having. World fisheries now. We're coming to the point. World fisheries, so now it is the reached global fish production estimated to have reached about 179 million tons in 2018. As per the FAO report, it has come like this. Total first sale value estimated at USD for 401 billion, of which 82 million tons valued at USD 250 billion came from aquaculture production. Of the overall total, 156 million tons were used for human consumption. Evaluate equivalent to an estimated annual supply of 20.5 kg per capita. The remaining 23 million tons were destined for non-food uses, mainly to produce fish meal and fish oil. As per that report, aquaculture accounted for 46% of the total production and 52% of fish for human consumption. China has remained a major fish producer, accounting for 35% of global fish production in 2018 too. Excluding that particular country, a significant share of production in 2018 came from Asia, 34%, followed by the America, 14%, Europe, 10%, Africa, 7%, and Oceania, 1%. Whereas global food fish consumption increased at an average annual rate of 3.1% from 1961 to 2017. And now, per capita food fish consumption grew from 9 kg in 1961 to 20.5 kg in 2018, by about 1.5% per year. Fish consumption is getting more. Whereas, as per the DFAO report, top 10 global capture fish producers 2008. You can see here, China, Indonesia, Peru, and India, about 36%. And top 5 inland waters capture producers, you can see India is second. Then again, Indian fisheries at a glance. As per our Department of Fisheries, area of the country, we have about 3.29 million square kilometer. A length of coastline is 8118 kilometer, as I already told you. In the EEZ also I told you, continental shelf also I told you. Whereas the fish production in 2017-18, million metric tons. Marine source itself 3.69, inland 8.90. Overall 12.59 million metric tons we achieved during 2017 and 18. Whereas export of fisheries products 17-18, that means financial year by April to March, the quantity this much, then value, you can see that 45,000 crores we are getting through exports. The contribution of fisheries to gross value added in 2016-17 current price is this much. You can see total GVA 0.96%, nearly around 1%, whereas in the agriculture 5.37%. This 1% only from fisheries sector. The population on March 31, 2001, as per the census, 1,028.7 million. Then again, on March 31, 2011, 1,019 million. Annual exponential growth rate 1901 to 2011 is 1.67%. Decadal changes in percentage 17.64. Then you can see the fisherman population engaged in fisheries activities. Number of family members, you can see 1,60,96,975. Almost half of the male, that is the 55,70,217. Females also equally giving response in this particular field. Engaged in fishing operations, full-time about 54 lakh, part-time about 32 lakh, occasional 24 lakh, and space paid about 49 lakh. Fish production during the recent years. Here you can see the increasing trend how it is changing some of the things. The blue says the marine, and red maroon, it is the inland, and the total is this much, how gradually increasing in lakh tons. Here, quite interesting chart we see here. See, percentage contribution inland and marine fisheries. Here, 50s, you can see inland only 29% and marine 71%. In 60s, 25%, 76%. In 70s, 38%, 62%. In the 80s, 36%, 64%. 90s, 40%, 60%. And then in 2010, you can see it is 61%, 39%. Again, 2017 and 18, you can see 71%, 29%, then almost 1950s and 2017. This is the thing, now culture fish is more aquaculture practices are going on in our country. so that these things we could achieve. Major fish producing states in India, these are the things: Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, Gujarat, Orissa, Tamil Nadu, etc., etc. Then marine fish production 2011-12 to 17-18, that is financial years, in lakh tons, can see 2011 Andhra Pradesh 4.33. Then again 4444. Again 2016 you can see 5, but 15 also 5, 2017 almost 6 lakh tons. Whereas other countries also, other states also following the same, almost they are maintaining their level. Gujarat also same, increasing. Tamil Nadu almost making their even. Then other things also, same way we are getting. The catches are increasing. Marine fish producing states and UTs 2017, Gujarat particularly 7 lakh tons. Then again Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and other states. Fish harvesting and marketing. Fish handling, post harvest is very must thing, because most of the people needed fish as a fresh. So we need to maintain, we have that responsibility to maintain the freshness of that particular catch or fish till to reach the customer door. Same way cold chain system also is there, that is being followed in nowadays. See, in this cartoon, you can see that fresh fish. One lady coming and asking to the fish vendor, fresh, whether fish is fresh, really fresh fish, totally. Then just opening that suitcase, then suddenly it jumping out. That much fresh only we people needed. Otherwise, it will be low valued. Thereby, our freshness on that particular catch and post handling, post after harvesting, all these things, a lot of technologies are available, lysing, everything, and how to handle without damaging the skin or pin or something like that. We need to know. Even public has to know, fisherman has to know, that everybody involved in that, everybody has to know. You can see the processing plant, how they neatly they are processing that pinletting, that tuna meat. Fish and fishery product, export and import at a glance. Again, separately, already I told you this, again, I'm separately telling you to easily understand how important these fish, how we are getting foreign exchanges, then how we are going to get all those things like that. You can see trend in marine fisheries export, marine export, how gradually increasing. You can see to the whereas 2005 6 some this much only 72 4 point. Then in 2017-18 45,000. You can see, you can imagine that how much we are getting through this marine export. Growth rate of marine fisheries export, about today it is 19.11%. Again, percentage of disposition of fish catch. You can see here 70% all we are eating. That means increased to intake. Intake level is increased in India. So this has then exporting as freezing, currying, canning, reduction, miscellaneous purpose, and unspecified, and the others are almost meager percentages. You can see here marine product export quantity in ton. You can see shrimp is more than other value added products. That means the frozen shrimp, frozen finfish, cuttlefish, squid, dried items, live items, chilled items, and other things. Again, you can see value in crore, which gives frozen prawns export, we are getting more money. Now, We come to know the process up to the marketing level. Then this much we caught, we pound out the craft, gear, we pound the resources, we caught the things, we exported, we got money. Then what will be the next? What are the things to be followed again? We are getting good money, foreign money, local market, this thing, that thing, like that. We are getting more and more from the sea means. What will be happen? So to read out that thing, we need to know the stock assessment. Or why we have taken more and more. There we are keeping something for our future, for our grandsons, their grandsons, something else. So what are the things to be followed like that? We need to think so that here stock assessment is required. Then again, revalidation of the particular stock. If we are getting more, the particular year, particular last 5 years, we got this much catch of particular tuna. Suppose elephant tuna, we got this many, then gradually increasing. That means what will be the stock for next? That thing to be carried out, that thing to be followed. Thereby, we can revalidate the things. So some of the things, we can control the fishing activity. This particular particular year, we need to catch this particular quantity only, like that. We need to do so sustainable fisheries management, everything based on the stock assessment. What are the stock? What are the potentially available in the sea for the future? Same way, revalidation in our country also happening every 10 years. Our office is one of the responsible office for doing this thing with the other state and the central institute. Those are working in this marine field. Thereby, to 1991, first report has come for the potential yield, that is 3.90. So again, 2000, 3.93 million tons. 2011, it was 4.41 million tons. The recent report says 2018, that is 5.31 million tons. These are the resources, million tons. Then these are the group. See that total during 1991. Whereas in 2000, these are the resources, these are the group, these are the potential yield for particular major resources. Again, 2011, or is in the reams wise, we can see pelagic, demersal, oceanic, or this much. Every time, all time, we should get the pelagic resources or more than other demersal and oceanic resources. Whereas in 2018 resources, you can see the pelagic resources. Again, as I said here also, more than again demersal, Lakshadweep, Andaman seas and oceanic. Everywhere we are evaluating this study. As per the revalidation study, the expert committee mentioning that top 10 resources contributing to the potential yield of 0 to 200 meter depth zone is oil sardine is more, then again Indian mackerel, ribbon fishes, pinnated prawns, croakers, other sardines, non-pinnated prawns, thread pin bream, something with fetches, Bombay duck, bivalves. These are the main resources we are getting through the 0 to 200 meter depth zone. Whereas in the resource potential of 200 to 500 meter, these are the thing region wise were analyzed. Thereby, northwest coast, that is latitude 15 to 23 degree north, 25. Then again, northwest coast 58,000. Then northeast coast 5. Northeast coast. Now southeast coast, northeast coast. Then so northeast coast 8. Recent stomach I have given here is the for this analysis, Wedge Bank and Gulf of Mannar are included in the southwest coast. Wedge Bank and Gulf of Mannar are having a lot of coral and the biodiversity and the protected area we are having over there. There are a lot of patches and other resources we are getting. Here again, 200, 0 to 200, 200 to 500 depth zones. What are the only demersal, pelagic, and the mixed resources? How much it is showing? Then again, the potential of the oceanic resources, particularly elephant tuna. Still, we are expert committee telling that 83,500 tons still we have. I am also one of the subgroup committee member in this. So we know the things that skipjack tuna also is here. We have resources here. I would like to say that as I am also one of the responsible person to provide the data in behalf of my department, analyzing on the other things, or I'm looking after reporting of that particular things to the IOTC, that is the Indian Ocean Tuna Commission. I also attended meetings on so. They are asking, your country getting more and more elephant tuna and skipjack tuna. There should be monitoring control over there like that. But we are giving information that we have plenty of resources. We are in India. We have multiple gear options, multi-day fishing, everything. We have enough resources. So we could not control that particular fishing on tuna. So like that, we are giving reply still. So we have resources, this thing, that way. The other sword fish, sailfish, billfishes also, these are all the large pelagic resources in the open sea, deeper waters. Again, you can see that state-wise and the coast-wise resources potential, the Gujarat, Tamandayu, and again, total west coast is this much. Again, east coast, this much. And then overall, mainland-oriented coastal states are having this much catches. You can see that Andaman and the Lakshadweep, this much. 1,21,000 of potential in tons. Now, remote sensing and fishery post forecast. Nowadays, fishermen need a little more technology to know exactly where the fishes are available. Instead of wasting a lot of fuel and energy to get the fishes, to search the fishes over there, now satellite-based information system also raised through ISRO and INCOIS, another system available in Hyderabad. Then ISRO space application center available at Ahmedabad. Then again, Bangalore. These are the things. So based on that, chlorophyll and the sea temperature, how oceans at to catching live this thing, image of that particular particular region ocean, particular regions fish cultures. So they are incorporating. They are incorporating. They can see that to. Where that particular fishes have been caught and how much catch was there, where there is any chlorophyll or not. If there is chlorophyll, means what are the fishes available over there, particularly more chlorophyll is there, means more pelagic fishes will be available. Again, we can see upwelling, downwelling, lot of things are is there during rainy season. Season wise, how seawater is changing while looking from the satellite. Imagine, then again, they are incorporating all these things. They can find to one conclusion like that. See here in KAIS producing kind of information like that. They can find out that particular chlorophyll for the particular region. Even day wise, you can see that particular sea temperature, how much it is there, chlorophyll is there, any upwelling, downwelling is there, upwelling. Downwelling also one of the process phenomenon to increase the more fish, juveniles and other things will be available in that particular area, particularly sardines and all in the west coast. We are getting more during that upwelling and downwelling changes. During rainy season, these things are happening. See, here you can see, but so to show to our beloved students, I took this is from the INCOIS website like that. Forecast validity from the 10th September 2020 to 11th September, 2 days fishes. Some souls are moving. Schools of fishes are moving over there. These are the area. Say, for example, Kaveri Pattinam, I think Trichy and the Karaikal areas. These are the from that particular place. We need to keep our boat or ship by keeping the direction southeast. Then bearing that particular degree, 96 degree, we are going means about 90 to 95 kilometer we are reaching means. These are the depth will come 2002 to 2213 kilometer depth of water. So there, that particular latitude will be this much, 11, 25, then 80, 42. There, these fish movements are there. It will be there for 2 days like that. Potential fishery forecast, everything they are giving day by day. Sometimes may not be able to give daily data because more clouds are passing means that particular satellite data may not get. Even though if anybody interested means fishermen or anybody, maybe some of the fishermen may listening to me, they can apply this one, they can send their mail, they can request with the inquiries, they can send you on daily basis. 2 times a day, they are sending this kind of forecast. It will be useful. This way, only schools, fish holes will be there. Then these are the things so satellite can catch. These are some of the movement is there. Their particular chlorophyll or some of the live feed, something are moving. Based on that, here forecasting that fish will be there, the fish eater. Then we could find this, pelagic fishes. What are the fishes previously we caught? What are things we may get in this particular region like that? We may come to the conclusions. Then now, number of fishes available in sea, ocean, as per the literature, the world, India, we need to know. As per these fishes of the world, estimated total number of fish species, 32,500 in year. This is about 2006, Nelson report only. In the identification book. Now maybe another 1,000 or 2,000 may be increased based daily, day by day. So many researchers are involving in this to identify, to exploit, explore more and more from the sea and freshwater and what are the resources available somewhere. So this will be increasing day by day. Again, fishes in the sea, fishes in the ocean, our Indian Ocean, as per the fish base is one of the reliable identifying site. We can see that 5462 is there in the Indian Ocean. Then fish species in the Arabian Sea, 976. The fish species in the Bay of Bengal, 772. Fish ecosystem in India, as per our Department of Fisheries, India is the third largest fish producing country and the second largest fish aquaculture fish producer in the world. India contributes about 7% to the global fish production. The country is also home to more than 10% of the global fish biodiversity and is one of the 17 mega biodiversity rich countries. We need to be proud about it. Again, fish diversity of India, native fishes, number of species, marine ecosystem, about 1518. Brackish water ecosystem, about 113. Freshwater ecosystem, about 877. This itself, 2508. And again, exotic fishes, this are, we are using in the culture forms as common carp, like that. Overall, 2,799 we have like that NBFGR is telling. See some of the commercially important fishes. This is the pomfret variety. These three we are getting. The first one is the silver pomfret, Argenteus, another Pampas Argenteus. Another one is the bigger one, Chinese pomfret, we could so to say. And again, we have Parastomitis niger. The sea fishes, four, five variety we are having, species we are having, mackerel, isle sardine, cobia, horse mackerel, catfish, Bombay duck, ribbon fishes. We have all these resources, plenty. somebody we can say that some of the species has been almost exploited, but as per my personal opinion, most of the things we need to explore more and more. Is there something is there into the sea? There are mystery. We need to find out more and more. We may not able to conclude this particular species not at all available like that. We are not putting more effort to that particular to exploit that particular resource. That may be the reason, I think so. Then again, Kerangis, polynemates, other fishes, groupers, emperor fish, threadfin brains, barracuda. Then again, crustaceans, tiger shrimp, deep sea shrimp, sandal, lobsters, crabs. Then cephalopods is this much, cuttlefish, squid itself, so many varieties are there, even deeper water. So many things are available. Octopus, only one this particular species are available in our country as on date. I used to see lot one or two, suppose 20 days I will be out at sea. In that one or two octopus only we will get. Because most of the species, once upon a time, this octopus species and all giant in nature. Nowadays, we are not at all getting that much big even. Coastal and oceanic tunas, these are the tuna groups we are having. These are the shark and string ray. Again, deep sea shrimps, these are the things. The deep sea lobsters. Then now, oceanic squids and the myctophytes. The status of the species. Then most of you has you are in the fisheries field, and my seniors and experts, those are listening to me in this webinar, they may know the things like that. The student, I would like to say that you please visit regularly this IUCN red list. There is one website, you can see what are the fishes least concerned, near threatened, vulnerable, endangered, critically endangered, extinct in the world, extinct like that. There are the group, they are modified to know the things, how the species condition to conservation like that. Conservation and nature, red list it is. We need to know the things. I used to see every month in this particular website, what are the fishes or least concern, near threatened, vulnerable. These first three category I'm still watching for every month. Sustainable fishery and harvest. Then again, sustainable fishery means what? Then again, harvest means what? That also question. Then fully fished, overfished, growth overfishing, bycatch, discard. So many terms are there. What are they like? What are they like that? Students, you please go through the studies. In your study time itself, you please need to know all these things. Then only your scope towards these fisheries will be good. Now, we come to know that CCR. What is CCR apply? Then I mentioned in that introduction slide, CCR apply. CCR is nothing but Code of Conduct for Responsible Fisheries. This is a product of FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, Rome, Italy. This is the book, manual. Anyone can read, anyone can follow. What should follow also voluntary and then mandatory to know all this thing. And actually, what are they in brief? As 12 slides, I'm telling all these things to you. You can see that enhanced fish stocks. This is one of the, like you can say as a slogan, how we can restock some of the area. We are almost taking out from the near shore. Now, most of the studies is saying that 0 to 70 meter, up to 70 meter, even 100 meter, we exploited more and more. Most of the species we got, even juveniles also we are getting. There is a need of our is the mess size regulation. So many things are, so many discussions, conflicts are going on. Again, artisanal fisheries, again, other industrial fisheries, people, these so many things are going on. For that, this if CCR of suggesting that some of the area you select, this particular area, these type of fishes are available. For that, we need to know what are the, how it is accommodating, how fishing grounds are there, coral bottom or coral habitat, or some of the grass like that. So like that means some artificial reefs and all by making in the cement, we can put. Like this, we are keeping some hold for that. Means they can breed over there. We can get good fishes, and bigger one we can caught over this. Then ban destructive fishing practices. Even ancient time also, this kind of activities going on. Still some places, somewhere it is going on. Putting poison, putting then crackers, and these things are happening. That should not be do in this. We need fully banned. Avoid overfishing. As you can see, left side, almost so many boats are there, and right side you can see one or two boats are there. What are the requirement is that much only they can catch and they can sell, they can survive on, because the livelihood behind this. But nowadays you can see so many people having so many commercial oriented fishing boats and more equipped and fish finding equipments, everything nowadays have come. But they were getting those things, then they are harvesting more and more. That to be avoided, that to be monitored, like that they are telling too. Next, to keeping fishing herbs clean. How could be cleaned? We can see that some of the fishing harbor now, lot of effort has been taken by the Department of Fisheries as a separate ministry in the Fisheries Department for central outcome. They are making a lot of effort through NFDB and directly from the Ministry of Fisheries. So that development, though, how hygienic we are keeping in the fishing harbor, only that product comes over crossing over their particular fishing harbor will be getting good amount, good value on that. We need to maintain neat and clean. Again, they're telling that use selective fishing gear. I mean, nowadays, so previously blindly we can fish like passive fishing, something comes, something goes like that. Active fishing nowadays increased a lot. We let them come, let them get it done, let them do money like that. So not like that. This code also telling that what you are going to do, which size of fish you going to do, we need to target accordingly. We need to replace the gears, fishing gears, fish nets, like that it's telling. Then again, encourage people's participation. People's is even a fisherman and a fisherwoman, everybody to be educated, the policy makers go and these are the things, resources are there, these are the stock, these are the things to do. Like that, we need to encourage people's participation over there. Then again, protect the critical fish habitats, even mangroves, most of the area we are losing mangroves. Even Mumbai and so many Kakinada, Andhra Pradesh areas and all destroying simply. That should not be, that to be saved, conserved for future. So these are the things so we can conserve for future. Then promote eco co-management. Co-management means everybody to be involved, all to be equal. Everything everybody should know in particular, suppose particular fisheries. Women or men, everybody knows their work, what it comes, what it goes, how to do this thing, that thing, everything to be discussed. Then only things will be understand equally. Again, minimize post-harvest losses. So without damaging the fish, we are properly icing, then properly handling, not throwing here and there, means we can get a good price, we can maintain good quality, this thing. So how we can minimize the post-harvest losses based on this proper icing, proper handling of the fish, these things and all to be followed. We were the responsible fisheries. Again, collect and record data. See, as I told you in the earlier slides, so then I also onboard a scientist participant, then and as well as the cruise leader of that particular voyage for 20 days. There, I used to watch everything. Then our skippers, captain of the ship, then bosuns will be the supervisors. Everybody will be there watching each and every changes. Then what are the fishes has come? Or what are the places we are operated? Everything, each and everything to be noted, to be recorded. So that gives a good and a realistic figure for future. Ensure safety and the health of the fishes. Fishermen should know safety measures, what are the things to be, if any emergency has come, means how it can escape from that situation. Suppose a fire, then fire alert, what are the fire alert, how who can be escape from so and so, like that everything should be known. They need to know the what are the navigational equipments are there, how to operate, how to call distress calls, and I'll need to make everything. They have to know. Even 5 people are there, 20 people are there, 100 people are there on board crew. Everybody to be trained. They should know the health saving equipments and other things too. Now the fisheries management. See everything we come to know. Now these are the things we known factor. Now you know the things. After knowing this, how we can manage the fisheries? What is fisheries management? The fisheries should be managed to ensure that fishing and fish processing are conducted in ways that minimize negative impacts on the environment, reduce waste, and preserve the quality of fish caught. This way, then important practice to be strictly followed. What are the things? Avoid overfishing, reduce waste, preserve the quality of the fish caught. Don't dump damaged synthetic nets into sea. A synthetic net into sea, please underline, you keep in the mind. I'm going to show some of the slides, so how it works. Destructive fishing practices to be prohibited, this also you keep in mind. Adapt to selective fishing methods. Selective fishing method, these are the fish I'm going to target. Suppose a shrimp. What are the shrimp to get the shrimp resources? Specific resource specific gear, that means the resource specific in the fish net to be fabricated, that to be used. Same way, cephalopods, same way, fish like that, we need to adapt. Can see here protective fish habits like coral reefs, mangroves. Preserve fish resources for future generation. Protect fish nursery grounds. As I told that some of the artificial cement blocks, something like that, no, so ring like that, we need to make. Then we need to known fishing grounds. We need to drop that one. We need to allow them to grow big. Avoid catching juveniles. Juveniles almost juvenile conservation almost be needed to know. Protect marine parks and the sanctuaries. Again, observe closer seasons. Closer season, recording closer season I have given here. What are the state or during what time they do not go for fishing. Fish ban period, you know. That coast-wise we have here, West Coast and East Coast. East Coast, what are the state including in this? When they're going to fish, how many days they should be in off, like that. The fisherman-centered sustainable fisheries. See here, destructive fishing. Still evidence is there. They are applying some of the things. Then they're putting crackers. And they're applying something, poison, something like that. They are immediately that fish will be float. It will be collected. That should not be. See, ghost fishing. These are the synthetic nets. Simply, if it is broken, means some way it will be broken. Obstruction bottom will be there. Net will be broken again. Pieces will come on board. Some pieces will be in the bottom of the sea. See again, some of the people, our unknown people, some of the people will throw that particular this thing also, pieces also into the sea. There you can see that the turtle and the shark, some other fishes and animals also get into that entangling and live their life. That should not be. We need to collect and put it in our shore. See, again, pollution also matter. We need to think about it. See, our children also over there, playing over there. Oh, neat and clean. We need to maintain this thing, has to be, think over it again. You can see right side bottom, dolphin. Again, in the middle bottom, you can see that a turtle. These are the things. And my suggestion also, it is suggested that ecosystem-based fisheries management include shifting from damaging to non-damaging fishing gear types. It has been suggested emphasis be given to educating both the fishing industry and the public about the importance of the ecosystem impacts of fishing and the need for ecologically friendly practices. And these are the fishing ban state-wise, how they adapted, when they adapted, how many days. Then again, here a type of fishing banned and type of fishing permitted during that particular ban period. Still we are having 6-7 days also is there. Central thing, again 47 is, days is there. Again, state level holidays also is there for monitoring this thing. This particular fishing ban coincides with the breeding season of maximum fish groups and other animals over here in the sea. Accordingly, East Coast and West Coast, they were divided, studied most of the fishes for particular season. Suppose monsoon, we are taking monsoon months, most of the pre-monsoon and monsoon time, most of the fishes are breeder, become a spawner. The fishery resources survey in international. Now I come to share you that during my visit international water cells, I have surveyed, participated for this international, how internationally how they are surveying for marine fishery resources and deeper water like that. Accordingly, among the nearly 30 scientists from other state, other countries, they were participated in this from a different discipline, marine fisheries, oceanography, and other technical people also have participated on board this particular voyage. Here it is there, the survey crew on board, Dr. Research Vessel, Dr. Pradap Nansen. Then again, during 19 July to August, Colombo to Chittagong have been traveled during that particular season, just post monsoon. Here you can see that in the deeper water only, Indian EEZ, I told you that Indian on the Indian EEZ itself, these things are happen because our Indian government have not given permission to enter our waters. That means above the international water only, these things are happened. In this slide, I'm going to show that Nansen, what is the Nansen program? Who's the Pradap Nansen? Observations in the deep sea and the other got from the participation in this thing. Over 40 years, the Nansen program has assisted developing countries in fisheries, research and management. Its principal concerns are to enhance food security through sustainable fisheries while contributing to global efforts to address ocean sustainability, such as marine pollution and the impact of climate variability and change on oceans and ocean life. Accordingly, 2018, they were planned this program. Previously, 1995 and 96, they were planned. After this many years, this plan now come. Then I took court opportunity to go on board with the international scientist. This is the research vessel, Pradap Nansen. The vessel flies the flag of Norway facilities from the Norway it has come. country of registration and the flag of the United Nations and OAS flag. FAO giving a lot of money for this, spending a lot of money for developing countries to know their resources all along the coast. This is the person, the great personality, Dr. Pradap Nansen from the Norway. Is a Royal Frederick University, then he is also a princess, he is a prince, then he's a scientist, explorer, diplomat, humanitarian. He got a Nobel Prize too, including other prizes. After 1896, his main scientific interest switched into the oceanography. In this course of his research, he made many scientific cruises, mainly in the North Atlantic. And contributed to the development of modern oceanographic equipment. So I inspired. This is the, that particular vessel, particulars. This is 2017 only, it has been constructed. New vessel, brand new. First voyage itself, I have participated. I'm proud of it. In this, this is about a 75 meter length. This is again accommodation about 45 persons, say crew, 15 crew plus 30 scientists can accommodate in this. These are the specifications. Laboratories and the scientific equipment, those so we need to have this kind of facilities in our own vessels, research vessels even. Still, we are having our Sagar Sampada on research vessel is there. We have this kind of, that's about 70 meters, 69 something. There are so these kind of facilities there. We are exploring the sea over that on board. Accordingly, here a lot of newly arrived equipments I have seen the, and the excited. Wet lab was separate, again fish lab separate, plankton sampling lab is separate. Then benthos, plankton, separate, everything separate studies, separate specialized scientists on board, technicians, lot of required things are available in this. Again, for oceanographical studies, CTD lab is separate. The bigger things are there. I'm going to show all those photos in future slides. The scientific equipment on board the ship includes CTD and the bigger things are happening for oceanographical studies as required by the Dr. Nansen. These are the instruments available, acoustic instruments, hydrophones, patrol geometry systems, hydrophones, catching monitoring system. So many equipments, sophisticated equipments are having to know actually what is happening in the sea like that we can come to know. This is the Mr. Captain. Buddha Sal is from the single man handling the ship. Even two assistants are there, assisting officers are there. A single man, 24 hours duties looking after everything here, online system monitoring. See, you can navigational chart also, computerized one, no paper, piece of paper, they are using it. Everything manual, automatically it will show in the navigational chart also where we are. Where towards we are going, what is the degree, everything it will show in the monitor. You can see that from the left there, the Norway is there. From the Norway, it has to steamed towards India, Sri Lanka, and again it was going to Thailand, and again another way for encircling the world. It will once again will go to the Norway. So we track and the sampling station from the Sri Lanka. These are the main station that the Indian on the line of the Indian AZ. We were traveled, took 14 days to reach Sri Lanka to Bangladesh. The first day on board, I was there. Net drum, separate is there for resource. Then again here, how they are operating in night fishing also. At midnight 2:30 is the particular area is coming, means whatever it is time we need to follow like that. We continuously were working 24 hours day night. These are the net shooting, multiple net, multi-purpose net. It is 64 meter, 62 meter, 62.4 meter. These are the specifications of that particular net. Here you can see the year we are in India. We are used to say we need, I already told you that 6 to 8 people should be there for handling the fish net. So here all things are mechanic and manual hydraulic machines they were using. See how they are operating. You can see this small video too, how they are operating the net. Only 2 men. Wireless winch control, everything is there. Only 1 man operating. In this matter and all, we need to develop a lot. We need to, as we are a developing country, we are towards this only. We to do all these things in future. See how hard working they are in deeper water. Sample collection. Now hauling back in the early morning troll it is. Sample collection and all. This left side you can see sensor. One of the slide I saw told you that next Sunday. This is then the red color and next Sunday. Some fishes are entering into this net, means we can easily identify. It will be fitted in the mouth of the net, particular net. Upper line. Head rope. Oh, these are the team from Thailand, the England, the other peoples. See, you can see me in the down also, in the 4 people, blue t-shirt. It's me. Collection of fish catch, the deeper water in future fishery. Almost we need to depend on deeper water as coastal and the shore resource we are almost exploited. The future fishery will be deeper water like that, they are telling. That's why this kind of study also people started. What are they there in the deeper water, how we can utilize for nutrition. So this, the sampling total catch is this much, then the fish shotting will be there again. We need to work out what are the fishes are there, group, again species, genus, this thing, that thing, everything there itself on the spot. We need to do, we need to work hard. It's a teamwork with the charted work. So night catch is this much, lot of krill and other things will come, then immediately will weigh and other things. This is the catch sampling, how we need to do everything systematic, everything we need to follow like this only. These are the things they are following. We too, I too got a chance to learn all these things. How they are sampling, sub-sampling, this thing, that thing, everything. Again, they are mainly targeted in this particular watch is mesophilic and the fish samples. These are the things, how to be sampled. Sample A, B, then how to be frozen, that particular samples by keeping all these things like that. Same way, these things are happen, fishing samplings and all. The samples for other things, jellyfish also, what are the things are available, everything to be recorded, things to be identified on board itself. See, sub-sampling, then sampling, preserving for future studies. They can see that he is one professor, Insan from London. He settled in South Africa now, he's a professor. Then it's me, then after manual identification, morphological identification, again we need to go for a deeper taxonomical studies again. As those deep sea, deeper water, krill and other organisms are too small, the well-developed microscope and the things are available, identification books are available on board. Again, we need to cross-check the things. There will be a taxonomist. There was a taxonomist from Austria, Robert. These are the lab we need to use definitely before and after other things. We need to neatly clean and keep over there. wet lab, they are maintaining like this, each and everybody having that cupboard, yellow, blue color. There all these accessories will be that particular voyage. Everything they full set they'll give, we need to maintain properly. Again, you need to record weight, length, this thing, that thing, area record, sampling stations, number, date, everything we need to know the things. In cache data, these are the main data they were collected. This is particular day, 25/7/18, particular day, latitude, longitude, these are the things. Shorted weight, number also is there. Again, total length, total cache, then sample number, everything we need to note it down. These are the main method they are following. This is the cache collection from the krill, mainly krill operation, also krill net is there. In that, what are the caches, how many species have come, how many quantity, and that what is the depth, everything we were studied. Again, cross check, this is right side, top is Mr. Robert, is from Australia, taxonomist, to verify. Here, onboard satellite connection will be there, we can use even net also. For identification, everything that control net controlled from directly from Norway, signal goes to there, they will provide us the required information. These are the some of the deep sea fishes we caught during that particular voyage. So the fishes, mictophytes, other benthosema and the gondostoma, diapus, and all we caught. Then again, plankton, the multiple plankton nets are available, different size for different purpose. Again, microplastic also they were studied, that also available in the deeper waters. These are the different plankton nets. These are the CTD sensors, the different to conductivity, temperature, and depth studies. These are the separate lab for oceanography. And one more interesting thing that in particular room, wherever you are, from there itself you can come to know in and around what are the things are happening, like that 24/7 camera view, live things we can see. These are the navigational live positions of the particular vessels, where towards where it's moving, like that. Again, captain and Michael Lepside, crew is leader of that particular voyage. This is Ma'am Diana from Norway, Dr. Mark Gibson from South Africa, is from UK actually. This is the efficient deckhands, helpers in the sample collections. And this is only three persons, they will prepare food for nearly 245 people, only these three people. Okay, any curry is there, like that, that chef asked me to, you please come and teach me your style for curry, I'll provide all this thing, like that. Then I'll try it once also, then again another day, I was just, rice is there, rice is available, because Indians also participated over there, Russian people is there, means there will be rice also, one of the item, a dish. Then that is some of the onion, then tomato, then one sardine canned fish curry I was using. Then after that, 1 or 2 days it has become normal. But one day, asked the first day, initially asked that chef is giving me this. This is chili, raw chili. If you require anything, means you cook like that. This is masala mixed one. Then left side, pure chili is there like that. So there were some of the things there from the union and the different parts of the country, different food and things will be there. We need to accommodate while participating this kind of exploration out at sea and with other countries. Then again, here washing, cleaning, everything we need to do. And this other thing, our place, there will be shipped for everybody. Lab, these other things. we need to keep neat and clean while finishing that particular sit. And again, our sub work, we use it to say in our ancient people also, our seniors also use it to say, we need to work as Englishmen like that. So because the scheduled work they are following, hours of work, working hours 12 hours means 12 hours per day, they definitely they are working. Then they have to take rest means how many hours to be take rest. And everything, they are systematic in their thing. Again, finally, this is one of my scientist friend from Norway. They were took this picture from the Sri Lanka. This actually Bombay duck, dry fish, Bombay duck. This is one of the lizard fish, right? In this, anyhow, she want to put in somewhere, she want to show in our report, final report. Then she asked me, I said this one, then she has put this. And as Shiva points out, this is how we ended the quiz like that. Then again, I have given the explanation why I told this. It means that rather than raw fish, dry fish has more nutrients. So we fetched good exposure on board the vessel like that. I go to clap also in this. Now we are come out of from the marine. Now we are going to freshwater, that to aquaculture systems. I think I'm not boring you, friends, and my seniors, experts, my professors. These are the things has been made to catch the mind of students. I'm going little wide. Aquaculture systems now. Preparation of pond before introducing PL. These are the things. This pond, it is plain land. It was there. 2004 to 2006, I have only developed one of the Sri Lankan company. It is, I have developed about 20 acre water spread area, aquaculture, integrated fish farming. Then again, I tried modern culture in freshwater, zero PPT also. Then duck compass culture, all the things I have tried here. And water management is very important in the aquaculture systems. They can filter what are the resources, the reservoir, then what, how many depth should be kept for the culture, how many days should be there, like that. A lot of processes there that should be maintained. Again, nursery and the growth ponds. This is what I developed over there, 26 acres. We need to maintain water quality in feed management, means we can get a good percentage of harvest rate in aquaculture systems. During my period, I have given about 70% in scampi culture, again 52% in monodon culture, and then again fish culture also we were done, that is about 45 or 50%. This is a good quality shrimp. We need to seed, that is the post larva. We need to select before introducing into these our nursery pond. Then how to be, we need to know that these are the one of the technique how to be released the PL to the pond. Then another technique port is there. We need to select the hatchery. Then how they are maintaining, how they are hatching out, how whether they are giving live feed or not. This thing, that thing, everything. One technical and technician should be there with you to select all these things. Here also, we can develop over this thing. Again, brooder selection also is there. Suppose we are going to keep single brooder, we are going to keep one lab, and this thing means nursery operation. We need to know all these things. See, you can see this fish prior fingerlings, so how healthy it is there, that we need to know. Then again, stocking up larvae and the segregation, okay, right side top, in the center sitting, it's me only. After nursery 40 days or 45 days, putting nursery in the scampi, particularly in Rosenbergi, we need to segregate that one. If we are segregating monoculture, we can do. So monoculture, we can get a bigger size than multiple male, female is there in the single pond means. So 60 days itself, some of the scampi will have the eggs. So to avoid that thing, we need to segregate the thing. The day itself per piece 10 paise, 15 paise for segregation. You should take the people from Andhra will come for the segregation purpose. The center sitting is mine only. Then again, feed per larvae size, according to the mouse size, feed selection also is one of the important criteria. The feed management is one of the main criteria to maintain a good pond management, water management, and other things, health of the candidate species. Oh, these are the methods for breeding. The right at the bottom. The right bottom, it's me only during 2004. I was working in the freshwater farm Scampi. We were checking about how feeding tech is, shrimp is taking over there. Again, grow out the fish. Again, some of the modern form from the Nathan Potap or them, or a doctor, one of my senior doctors, Sinha, shared these views, though he is presently working over there. Again, growth and monitoring. We need to see here, I think one video clip is there, you can see here. See, for sampling purpose, how growth is there, then again, this thing and all we can see. For any infection is there, parasite is there, means we need to treat for frequent monthly ones or 1.5 month ones. We need to sample the thing. We need to study all those things, any parasite or something are there not. Growth checkup. Again, partial harvest also we need to do in freshwater and all. Partial harvest is must. Complete harvest in the prawn farm, there how water to be taken out, the thing to be carried out. Again, post harvest process and all we need to see. Post harvest means proper icing and keeping in the box tray with the proper icing. Then we can maintain the quality of that particular things. Again, drying out the pond after harvesting. These are the things to be done. See, if proper feed management and water management is not there, means first left side, you can see that pond bottom will be like this. That should not be there. More organic waste will be there. That will be taken out. That way only these operations are going on. You can weed out in the pond, this thing also one of the process to maintain the pond. Then again, after harvest, lime application to disinfect the ponds, another insect and everything will go. Then again, bleaching, the plowing also required for good aeration of that pond bottom. Integrated form, duck cum fish culture, as I told, these are the yield egg we got over there. Paddy and mango cultivation using exchanged water as open anyhow monthly once we need to exchange the water from the aquaculture systems. That water anyhow we need to use like that. We were developed about 4 acres of paddy field and again mango, everything utilizing this, pumping this water into that. Again, strengthening of fishers' capacities, these are things, education, fishing industry adaptation, regular stakeholders meet, training from reputed training institute, certificate or term courses to be attended, even students and other fisher folks. Limitation still is there, a lot of fluctuations in the like agriculture, here also price decrease, increase are there, not proper price are getting like that, there are complaints even. Lack of cold storages and the safety at sea, the navigational life-saving equipments, life insurance, these are the limitations still we are facing. We need to improve a lot in this. Again, future fishery towards like this only, towards the deeper water only. Economic development and the recreation required, improved data collection, scientific assessment required, greater stakeholder participation, national and international meetings, these are all the things of a discussion we need to know. See, here reality is that the fish itself, now they got alert. There they go with another net full of fish, they are telling. Then the way governance are subsidizing overfishing, the oceans will be empty, another fish they were talking. And then there will be a big case of empty net control. These are the things. You can see below this thing, past, present, and the future, how it will be decreasing the resources. Then again, future will be right side bottom. You can see there will be one fish. So you get or me get, this way only. Take me, you take like that, no one will say. Give me too like that, they will be the struggle. So we need to save the resources. The future fishery will be like this. To think about the things again, miss size, regulation, this thing, that thing and all. That everything we need to know. Again, in the hidden story, you can see here, find the hidden story lesson. Left side, you can see man looking slim and fish is bigger. Then again, here you can see nowadays a small fish, big. That means the consumption is more. Again, another scientifically, we are seeing means some from the side, one side we are telling that we have a lot of things, we give subsidy, this thing, that thing. The scientists are thinking that we are studying where is fish, how they are telling, then we are confusing. So cyclone rescue operations also we developed a lot, ISRO and other institutions and the remote sensing satellite based technology developed a lot, still we need to develop. Again, eat fish, be healthy. International bodies for regulation, Food and Agriculture Organization, Indian Ocean, Tuna Commission, Bay of Bengal. These are the things continuously monitoring the things. Here you can see this PMMSY, our Department of Fisheries and Initiation. You can see the things. With this, another few slides will be there. With that, we are coming to the conclusion. I think most of the time I'm taking. So I'm interested to share the knowledge with others. See, these are the resources we have. Our fisheries department also. Taking initiation to develop this particular field a lot, making forward. In this one video clip itself, you can understand our resources. This is the thing. There is a lot of scope in the future for the student, for their higher studies, PhD degrees, and research. Your everything is indigenous. These are the aim of our government. Some more post I will play. This single video itself, you can see that all the resources, what are the possibilities to get a good job, to research everything. Next successful, though so many successful persons have been succeeded in this fisheries field as a researcher, fish farmer, fish feed manufacturer, technicians, businessmen. So many are there still, they are succeeding their life in this particular field. Share the research experience, everything almost I have covered. Our colleges, institutions for education, research and development, survey, training, a lot of institutes are there. All maritime states having fisheries institutions, ICR institutions, itself almost 7 to 8 institutions are there to read about this fisheries field. Then coastal aquaculture authority is there in Chennai, Fisheries Survey of India. Then Central Institute of Nautical Technology to give training for handle the ships and all, and engineering, marine engineering and everything. Then again, National Institute for Post Harvest, we need to post-harvest technology, need to be followed, that they are giving trainings. National Fisheries Development Board is there to train and give subsidy to develop the particular field. Then again, Marine Product Export Development Authority is there to develop again export and shrimp culture. Then scope in the field of fisheries, you can get a degree in the fisheries teaching line, you can go become a researcher, fishery business you can do, maybe an entrepreneur, maybe the fish processor, a selling of value added products, maintenance of cold storage, then again fish farming, shrimp hatchery and the farming, and ornamental fish aquarium shop and store, even breeding point also you can keep. And again, mollusk and seaweed farming and other fishing gear fabrication and selling, importing and selling. And again, construction of aquaculture systems, and dry fish, smoked fish selling business, ice manufacturing units, a lot of things are there to depend the fisheries field. The woman job opportunity for woman also is there, a lot of things, research, teaching, business, marketing, self group, everything we can, so the women can achieve in this, lot of things. This already told you. Accordingly, you can see that a lot of fisheries colleges are there, list of universities and other things. You can see various degree they are providing. Dedicated institute are there to this. And thank you for the patient listening.
आज तो बाकी सब कंप्लीट कर दिया फिर आंटी.
Thank you very much. Thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Nice presentation and clear cut presentation about fisheries. Thank you very much. So participant, if you have any question, unmute your mic and ask your question. Participant, unmute your mic and ask your question.
First of all, thank you very much for patient listening, participants, seniors who are there, professors. Please ask your questions, any clarifications, anything.
From Arun Kumar, sir, FIS will be conduct any training program or webinar? Will we conduct any training program or webinar?
Yeah, we are in plan. We can
Shiva.
Yes, madam. Listening you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. So it's time for formal vote of thanks. I invite Dr. Balasubramaniam, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology, Anjaranna Arts College, Cheyyar, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good evening, one and all. I deem it my good fortune to propose a vote of thanks on this national webinar. I like to express sincere thanks to our respected principal to permit the conducting the webinar. I would like to thank our HOD, Dr. N. Punida, organizing this webinar. My heartfelt thanks to resource person of this webinar, Dr. A. Shiva, scientist, Fishery Survey of India, Mumbai, for spending valuable time with us. I would like to thank our faculty members. My hearty thanks to all the participants taking part in this webinar. I once again thank everyone for making this program grand success. Thank you, Unnada.
Thank you very much for participant, patiently listened. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much for your support. Mama,